Hello everyone, so today we are back again with a topic that is a concept of development. Before starting with the topic, I'd like to request every one of you to please subscribe our channel, those who are new to it. For this, you just need to click the bell icon which is given just below this video, and if you like the video, then please the like button. In the previous video, I have already published about the CET, that is a Central Teachers Eligibility Test, on which we are going to give about what is a CET, applicability, the validity period, and as well as the structure of the exam, and also on how the exam pattern and the syllabus, basically the syllabus on which it is take place. Now in this, we have seen that is divided into basically two papers, paper 1 and paper 2, that is divided according to the classes and the gradation of the classes on which we have the child development and pedagogy is common on both the papers. So from now onwards in our channel, we are going to give the topics regarding the CTET and also regarding geography that will be of help for the competitive exam, the forthcoming competitive exam. So starting with the topic, I'd like to request every one of you to concentrate, and so we are going to talk about development. So what is development? The term development is refers to the various qualitative and quantitative changes, and it takes place simultaneously with the changes to growth. It is a progressive series of mannered and coherent changes. These changes is related to the growth and the moves towards the maturity. This growth is always related to this physical, mental, emotional state of an individual in the behavior of the individual. In the next, we are going to see the picture. It basically states that it is a progressive series, that is basically in the second diagram, which notes that is a progressive series that are mannered and coherent changes, and these changes are related to the growth, and it's as it moves towards the maturity. The growth is related always to its physical, mental, and emotional state. And in the first, we are going to see that it's a qualitative and quantitative changes of development. In the next slide, we are going to see about the characteristics. So from the first characteristic, which is very common, that is a continuous development from the moment of conception until it reaches to the maturity. Next, we are going to see that it's an orderly mannered. It cannot be in out of this order. That is basically it's from the infancy leading. It's from infancy leading to this early childhood, leading next to late childhood, adolescent, and ultimately leads to maturity. So in this sequence is needed to be followed. Next, it is a both qualitative and quantitative changes. Basically, when the child grows physically, develops qualitative aspect of his personality. It's also a complex phenomenon, that is a factor that affected are the sex, physical intelligence. The next, it rates the predict or the rate of development by seeing a slow learner or a superior child. Next, the last one is the individual differs from each other in the rate of development. So basically, when we're talking about the characteristics, these are the basic characteristics which comes into our mind at a glance. Next, we're going to see about the types of development. Now, in this development, we always refer to different types that may be of a physical, cognitive, social, emotional, language, and moral. The physical development is very common. Now, we're going to talk each of them in a vivid manner. So talking first of the physical development, which is very common, we see in our eyes, and it is being recognized in observable changes. It includes gross motor skills as walking, jumping, the fine motor skills like printing, writing, largely dependent on the child health and the nutritional status. And the this type, that is basically the physical development, always refers to maturation, while the cognitive development focuses on how the children learn and process of information. It understands the environment using the sense, registering the information in the mind and efficiently retrieving it from the memory. It indicates the development basically of intelligence. And the third one is the social and emotional development. It is an indicator of social development among the children, develop social skills like sharing, cooperation, patience in their interaction with peers and others. The social development is basically, the ability to have in accordance with the social exceptions, while the emotional development here is basically the ability to control and manage one's emotion. The fourth one is the is a language development. The what we mean by language? Language is basically the interaction with one another through the various means or methods of communication, that is writing, speaking, sign language, etc. And it is an important medium of communication. While language is a form of communication and uses words and symbols to express the thought, desire, and expression of an individual to another individual. The last one is a moral development. It deals with the development of ethics and ethical norms to value this consciousness and the ability to judge and act morally. This moral development gradually develops as a person matures towards its maturity. So in the next we're going to talk about another topic, that is growth. So what's the growth? We see growth and relate growth as a physical growth or mental growth, but it's basically a shape and growth in weight, that is a height and change in the body proportion. It basically also refers to the physical growth as growth of different parts of the body and ability to those parts of to work. So now we have understood what is development and what is growth. So we can quickly find the difference between the two. So as given, the first difference is that it is purely in the physical sense in the growth, and it generally refers to an increase in the size, length, height, and weight of an individual. It changes in both qualitative and quantitative domain. While the development is a overall changes in shape, structure, resulting in an improved working or functioning, it indicates the change in the quality and character. In the growth, its change is being produced by growth are subject of measurement and may be quantified and are observable in nature. While in development, it implies the environment in functioning and behavior. It is a qualitative change. It's difficult to be measured directly. In growth, it is just a one part of the development process, while development is a quantitative aspect in the terms as growth. But in development, it is a wider and comprehensive aspect, and it refers to the overall changes in individual, and growth is one of its part. Next we have that this major may, that in growth the major or the person may not bring development. A child may grow by becoming fat, but this may not be regarded as any functional improvement in development. While in development, when the some children do not gain in terms of height or size, but do not experience the functional improvement of an individual. This point is not written there, so I'm explaining it. And the last which is written is that it is does not continue throughout the life. So basically growth is restricted to a certain period, basically to the first phase of life, and it's stopped when the maturity has been attained. While in development, it is a continuous process due to not end, it will not end within the attainment of the maturity. So when we have attained maturity, we are gaining one or the other development. Then next we have the factors of development. It is the last slide, and I am going to detailly clearly explain the factors which leads to development. Is basically common the heredity. It is a biological process, and this heredity is help in the transmission of the physical and the social characteristics and the aspect of the height and weight, structure of the body, color and hair and eyes, and the independence, aptitude and instinct of an individual carried hereditarily either from the father's side or the mother's side. The next is the environment. This environment is the sum total of the physical and the psychological aspect of the individual. The third one is the nutrition. It's a healthy development of an individual in terms of physical and mental aspect. It depends on the food habit and the nutrition the one is being consuming. It's important of a structural and functional aspect of a child. The fourth one is the sex. Basically, we have seen that the boys are generally taller and courageous compared to the girls, who are have rapid growth in the adolescent, but the body constitutional and structural growth of the girls are comparatively lower than compared to the boys when they attain the maturity. Next, we have early stimulation. In this early stimulation, we encourages the development of a child hereditary potentials. A stimulating environment encourages good physical and mental development, while this unstimulating environment causes the child to fall below this potential, which he or she may inherit from its family. The last but not the least is a child rearing practice, which we thought is not a very important, but it plays a very important role, as it creates a sense of responsibility, it creates a sense of emotional control, the personal and social adjustment of an individual, which he inherits from another, that is from hereditary. So we are end of this. In the next day, we are going to talk about the stages of human development. And with this, I'm coming to this end of my presentation. If you clearly like this video, then press the like button.